Praise God, everybody. I pray that you are all well. Yesterday, I posted a word where the Lord was telling us that it's time to begin separating ourselves from relationships, ending relationships that we know and understand that we are not called to be in. If you haven't listened to that word, I strongly suggest that you go and listen to it and then come back to this message. So, in continuing on in that, the Lord is offering some reasoning here and some understanding as to why it is essential that you separate from these people. In some cases, these people are hindering your ability to hear what God is calling you to do. And it's very important that as we move into these times, that you have an understanding of the things that God called you to do and that you have an understanding of who God called you to be. He's taken me to Matthew chapter 16, verses 21 to through 23. And in this, you see that Jesus is describing the events that must take place. He is describing that he is going to be persecuted and he will be harmed. And you have Peter, who is a trusted friend and disciple, coming to him and rebuking him, pulling him aside to tell him, no, don't say that. Don't speak those things. Surely those things won't come to pass. And then you see that Jesus rebukes Peter, calls him Satan, and tells him to get behind him. And so looking at this occurrence in the natural, it seems a little odd, right? If you tell your friend that something terrible is going to happen to you, their reaction to you would be, well, no, don't speak like that. Don't say that. But in this case, Jesus was fully aware of what the Lord's intention and will for him was. And it didn't match what sounded or seems good in the natural. So here you have this person that you call friend, or you have this person, Peter, who is in this position of closeness, who is telling him that the events that will take place are not what God said. So if Jesus wasn't 100% clear about what the Lord told him was going to take place, if he didn't know that he knew what the Lord said, Peter's actions and his words would have completely confused him, and it would have knocked him off course to fulfill the calling on his life. Praise God. And so what the Lord is saying is that these people who are in your life may not have bad intentions, but through their actions and through failing to be aligned with the Spirit of God and what the Spirit is saying and what the Spirit has forecasted over your life will advise you to go into some things that you don't have any business going in. They will advise you to leave behind some things that you shouldn't leave behind. Their advice to you will be in direct opposition to the word that the Lord has given you. So I charge you, brothers and sisters, to take this to the Lord. Take this word to the Lord, because this is essential. These people have got to go. I am not saying that they're bad. The Lord is not saying that you need to ghost them or you need to turn your nose up at them. But he is saying that it is pivotal that you separate yourself from these people so that you can clearly hear him and that you can clearly fulfill the purpose and the calling that is on your life. Praise God. Be blessed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this word. Thank you, Lord, for the ability to share it. Brothers and sisters, if you do not know Christ, if you have any question about where it is you are going after you leave this earth, send me a message. You can leave a comment in the comment section, or you can email me. You can schedule a free one-on-one call. But it is essential in this day and age that you hear the voice of the Lord and that you have a clear line of communication between yourself and the Father. That looks different for everyone, but it's essential that you have your own unique way that you hear the voice of the Lord, so that when he calls you to do something, you can stand on it. When he gives you a word, you can stand on it, trusting and understanding that you have heard correctly. Praise God. I love you all so much. Be blessed. Until next time.